us in a place of shame. It leaves us in a place of isolation. And when we do that, and when we allow the words of other people to make us feel so worthless, we give away our power so much that we fail to celebrate our efforts. She was so worried about what people would think, what people would say, and she was not taking time to really celebrate the fact that she was taking steps forward. At least she was trying to. And even with meeting with me just one-on-one, I felt like she was even almost trying to talk her way out of going forward with her goals because she was so dedicated to this story of being self-conscious, feeling like, you know, she's too big, feeling like she's let herself go. And we can worry about how we've gained weight all day long. You know, we can worry about how we've let ourselves go all day long. We can even worry about the people who will laugh and pick at us. But we can make that the focus, or we can focus on the fact that I'm doing something today because I can't go back and change what led to my experience in this moment. But I can make the best of right now, and I can silence any naysayers, and I can press forward, and I can maintain my focus because I'm living to make myself healthier, and I'm not living to satisfy someone else's opinion or someone else's take on how I have handled my life up to this point, especially if I'm pressing forward to make the positive changes. That's what you got to hold on to. You can't hold on to the offense, because people are going to offend you even when you rock and crush your goals. People have something to say then. Me and my mom used to talk about the fact, especially when we were like both bigger and we were trying to lose our weight. We were like, well, when people see us and we've lost weight and we're looking better, they'll think, well, are they working? Are they able to buy food? You know, do they have groceries? Are they doing okay? You know, they're smaller now. It's like no matter what side you're on, when you're bigger, they're going to have something to say. When you lose the weight and you're toned and fine as I don't know what, they're going to still wonder, well, is something going on? I mean, people will always have an angle. And if you invest your energy being offended by all of those outside voices and all of those outside opinions and all of those people who try to make you feel worthless, if you invest energy there, then your soul will always be wounded so easily. So carry it so high, as Renee taught us. Carry it so high that no man can touch it. Carry it so high that you know the choices that you need to make for yourself. Whether somebody is cheering you on positively or whether they are trying to knock you before you even get started, make sure your soul is so high that you press forward in spite of the good, the bad, the indifferent. For both your soul and your self-confidence, it is so high that no one can touch it and no one can destroy it but you. Guys, I hope you enjoyed my talk today on squats. I hope you enjoyed my quote for today. I hope that you enjoyed the whole episode. If you are enjoying the Squat Wisely podcast, please head over to our Facebook page. Simply search Squat Wisely and give our Facebook page a like. You can also subscribe to the podcast by heading over to iTunes. You can search Squat Wisely on iTunes and subscribe there. If you are an Android user, you can check out Stitcher and search Squat Wisely to subscribe there. Also, no matter which one you use, whether you are an Apple iPhone person or an Android user, you can listen to us through iHeartRadio using either device. All you have to do is search Squat Wisely and you'll be able to check out the show there as well. Guys, thank you so much for listening. You know I'll be back next time to do this all over again.
Get a world-class motivational speaker to your next event. Kristen Hester offers professional speaking services in Atlanta, Georgia, and beyond. To hire Kristen, visit www.kristenspeaks.com. K-R-I-S-T-E-N.
You've been listening to the Squat Wisely podcast. Professor Kristen Hester is a philosophy professor, fitness professional, and motivational speaker. For well over a decade, she's led philosophy courses within the University System of Georgia. Kristen leads group fitness classes in Atlanta, as well as leading one-on-one personal training sessions. She strengthens the body as well as the mind. We'll see you next time on the Squat Wisely podcast with Professor Kristen Hester.